got your moonshine!
You're a wonderful man! Wonderful!
You got my money?
It's for a very good cause. My name is Professor Andrew Bell III. Perhaps you've heard of me.
Can't say that I have.
Oh, I'm an inventor. Maybe you've read about me.
I don't read much.
Well, that's too bad. Oh, yes.
You got my money?
Oh, well, it is the most wonderful invention, friend. Oh, you, sir, have done a great deed.
All I've done is get some creep a lot of drink.
Creepers? Excellent. Nonsense. Now, you've helped me develop the most humane machine imaginable. A way to induce calmness to our most troubled souls. A way to end the barbarity of a public hanging. Oh, so, so humane.
What are you talking about?
The electric chair.
What?
See, it's a chair full of electricity. It's quite fascinating. It calmly and peacefully dispatches sinners to face judgment. Yes, judgment.
Yeah. Where is it?
Well, it's in my laboratory. The next thing I need is a demonstration. A public one. Huh. Do you know the police chief?
As well as anyone.
Oh, wonderful! Perhaps you can encourage him to let me demonstrate the chair. It will help bring this town into the next century. Yes, could you do that?
Come on, girl.
So, welcome to our humble police house. Can I help you with something? I can't possibly help you if you don't tell me what you need.
Chief, I'm representing the inventor of a humane execution machine. An electric chair. And he wants to demonstrate his invention here.
Ah, I'm familiar with the man and his work. Tell you what, I'll give you a permit. But it's gonna cost you $100 in fees.
Okay, well, the price is fair. Here you go.
And here, sir, is your permit. Pending the usual formalities, of course, such as finding a suitable candidate for humane dispatchment.
I'll tell that to the professor.
Good luck.
Hello, mister.
Watch your step.
Not good.
Hello.
Come in. you do.
Hello, Professor... Professor...
Andrew Bell the Third.
That's it. So, the Chief says you can test out your machine. The usual formalities.
And what are they?
Finding a suitable, subject.
Ah, funny you should mention. This fella here, he seems sturdy enough, and he's guilty of sin.
Wilson J. McDaniels. Wanted for murder, bigamy, and immoral animal husbandry. What's that?
The mind shudders. Ugh. Here, find him for me and help me put him out of his misery.
Friend, all right. You're gonna be okay.
You're gonna help me? I need a doctor. You gotta.
Jesus, unbelievable.
Please.
Hey,
please, do something.
I'll get you help. Just stay alive.
Okay. Okay. Where am I?
Don't you give up now.
Something else out here every day.
I'm dying. This is it. My arm. can't feel it anymore.
All right, friend. All right, we're at the doctor.
I don't want any trouble.
Oh, good God. Quickly, bring him in here. Right here. Sit him down in this chair.
What happened?
Just saw you fall out of the saddle. Don't worry, you're at the doctor.
Thanks, friend. I appreciate it.
Sure.
There's also the matter of my payment. But we'll deal with that later.
All right.
A lot of blood loss. This wound's badly infected. I'll save as much as I can, but I'll have to amputate.
all right, girl. Yeah.
Think it was gonna come to this, did you, idiot?
Thank you.
special treat for you.
You're your own jailkeeper, mister. In a prison of your own making.
You're coming with me.
Take me to damn court, then.
Sounds like sour grapes. You know, you ain't going to court. You ain't going to jail either. I'm taking you to a professor I know.
What in hell are you talking about?
You're a lucky man, mister. You get to be part of a great experiment.
Shut up!
You ain't gonna die needlessly, is what I mean. Nope. Your death's gonna be an important step in the advancement of human knowledge.
What the hell are you saying, mister?
This professor, Andrew Bell III, I believe he said. He's a little odd, maybe harebrained, but I got no reason to doubt the quality of his work.
What's this damn professor got to do with anything?
Well, he wants to try this new electricity chair on you, to kill you, humanely.
No!
Yeah. Well, he's gonna strap you into this contraption and run a large electric current through your system. Got something to do with moonshine. Don't quite know what. I guess that's why he's a professor and I'm the bounty catcher. Well, as I said, I can pass on his assurances that this is a moat. Humane way to go. It'll be just like, well, like switching off a light.
They wouldn't let you do this. Me? They wouldn't.
Oh, they would. And we got a permit and everything. You was in animal husbandry, am I right? Well, you ever seen lightning strike livestock, Mr. McDaniels? Now, I ain't ever seen the actual impact, but I came across a pasture sometime after. The storm had just cleared, and there was smoke in the air, smell of burning hair.
No.
There must have been a dozen head of cattle, lying there, piled up, mangled. Strange scars across their backs, legs, and necks. It's half like they was burned, half like the skin was ripped off.
No.
Eyes bleeding. Some of them popped out.
No.
Daniels, you all right? Yeah, me too. Well, you'll be happy to know we ain't got far to go. Hold on tight now. We're going. Thank you. professor will be real pleased to meet you.
No!
Here, I got him.
You're wonderful. Just
wonderful. Come on. Don't be shy now. Let's go.
Put him down just there.
Now, where's my money?
Money?
Yeah, for all the running around I've been doing.
Well, once they buy my humane electric ending facilitator, there'll be money enough for you, sir.
Yeah, let's hope.
All right, let's get our poor unfortunate ready for the demonstration. Oh, do come and watch. It'll be amazing. Come along.